Once you've finished taking off all the existing and proposed information on the same page, whether it's spots or contours, it's time to send this information to Earthwork Pro. To launch the plugin, click the bulldozer icon in the Home tab ribbon bar. This window is where you'll use Earthwork Pro to quickly and accurately calculate the cut or fill needed to grade the job site based on the takeoff data from your drawing. Let's maximize the window and take a look around. Across the top, you'll find several tool groups. The first group is Zoom/Pan. You can click these buttons to zoom in or out on the page or fit the page to the window. Alternatively, you can hover over the image and use the scroll wheel on your mouse to zoom in and out and click and drag the page around by holding the left mouse button. The next group, Image Tools, contains several buttons that let you hide or show hidden items on the page, clear the image so you can see the drawing better, or refresh the image to bring all the data back. However, the Print button is the most important button in this group. We'll discuss why a bit later in the video. The image on the screen shows the existing and proposed topography in brown and blue. If you'd rather use a different color palette, you can change the existing and proposed colors using the topography colors. Now again, the point of the tool is to calculate the cut or fill needed to grade the site. To calculate the results accurately, Earthwork Pro creates a grid over the site and then analyzes the existing and proposed elevations to find the difference. The smaller the grid, the more precise the results. However, smaller grids also take longer to process, especially on large-scale plans. You can adjust the grid size using the Grid Size menu. There are options from as small as 0.25 by 0.25 to as large as 5x5. The value depends on the measurement system in place. So 0.25 by 0.25 in Imperial means a quarter foot grid size. In metric, that would be a quarter meter grid. For this example, let's stick with the 1x1 grid. Click the Calculate button to calculate the cut and fill required for the plan. Once finished, you'll see the cut in red and the fill in blue covering your proposed area. Zooming in, you'll see the cut and fill represented by triangles. You can change the symbol to a different shape or color using the cut and fill graphics options at the top. Click the Clear Grid button at the top and recalculate to see the changes. You can keep clearing the grid, adjusting, and recalculating until you're happy with the results. The results appear on the Estimating tab inside a folder named after the page. You can see the folder on the right side of the screen in the Calculated Topography panel. Sometimes you want to calculate the cut and fill again to compare with the previous calculation. If so, be sure to change the name of the folder. Otherwise, the previous results are overwritten. One more thing before we send the results to PlanSwift. The visual representation of the cut and fill does not display anywhere else in the program besides right here inside Earthwork Pro. Remember the print button from earlier? If you want to save the image for review, you must print it now. You don't have to print the page physically, you can print it as a PDF. You can even import that PDF image back into your project if you wish. All right, now all you need to do is click the Send to PlanSwift button to send your results, and you can close the Earthwork Pro window.
Before you build, construct Connect.